So we are discussing about the quad trees. Trees, we are discussing the trees, and quad means four. So what we mean when we say four in trees, let's see about that. Because these quad trees are finding its application everywhere in geometry, in spatial data structures. So if you talk about computer graphics, games and movies, you'll find these quad trees. In computer vision, CAD, street maps like Google Maps and Google Earth, they are using these quad trees. And also human computer interface design like windowing system, virtual reality, virtualization or visualization. These are graphic complex functions which we are using with the base as the quad tree. What about the geometric objects? Geometric objects are, they can be scalar, they can have just one point. So this point, which is a location in some D dimensional space, and D tuples could be, P can be represented by x1 to xd, and the arrays can be found or can be made like double PD. The structures could be structure double and xyz. And a very good compromise of this geometric object is we take a point, then we describe the dimension dim as 3, and then we say the double or any data type, the double will always be good, coordinate as dim, that is the dimension, that is 3. What about the vectors? Vectors are the direction and magnitude or length in that direction. And when we talk about the line segments or rays, line is infinite in both directions. It follows an expression y is equal to mx plus c or ax plus by is equal to c. In this case, m is the slope, b is the y-intercept. And in the higher dimension, any two points may define a line. What about a ray? It is infinite in one direction. Segment is finite in both directions. A line, a segment and a ray. Then we come to the polygon. Polygon means the cycle of joined line segments. So they are line segments only, but they are joined. First and last vertex should be same, point should be same. So means polygon can be simplex, these lines cannot cross. Convex, if any line segment connecting two points on its surface lies entirely in this shape like this. And convex hull of, what is convex hull? This is hull of a set of point P, the smallest convex set that point P would contain. And what is the good representation for a polygon? Can we use the circularly linked list of points? In the geometric or geometry, we have certain operations which we need to see and understand. For example, if this is P and Q, these are vector going from point P and Q, so we can perform this P minus Q. If this is say a point Q, as we have just suggested, and Q plus V can be a point at the head of the vector V, if which is ahead or head of the vector V, if V were anchored at a certain Q, so this is Q plus V. What about V plus U? If we serially walk along V and then U, then V plus U is the direct shortcut. And we can use these in terms of some programming language. You can use C++ overloading, operator overloading to do exactly that. So there are certain queries that we are interested in. Is the object in the set? What is the closest object for a given point? What objects does a query object intersect with? What is the first object hit by a given, say, ray, that is ray shooting? And what objects contain this P or points? What objects are given in range, that is range queries? So let us see this diagram. What about the intersection of a circle and a rectangle? This is our circle, say C. This is our rectangle, right? And this rectangle is bounded by, say, this is rho low and rho high. Rho high and rho low. So they are bounded by these four points. Okay. This is first dimension, this is the second dimension. Say. We have a circle. So how do you compute the distance from the circle center to the rectangle? What can be the distance? Is this the distance? Is this the distance? Or is this the distance? We can perform the intersection of circle and rectangle. How? So instead of we can have special cases. We break down or break the distance down by dimension, that is the component. Okay. So the distance could be the square root of the sum of the squares of the distance in each dimension. That can be say dx, dy and dz. So dx square plus dy square plus dz square. That is the this x cr and this y cr. And you know what c and r are, radius and center. So distance cr is 0 unless C is in the blue region. C is not in the blue region. Of course, the distance would be zero. But we'll use the simple Euclidean distance, which we can formulate. So how about distance from C to R? Distance C to R, we start with distance equal to zero, and for each dimension, we find out if Ci is less than or equal to R dot low I. You know what low was. So we add the distance like this: square of R low I minus C I. This is square. Otherwise, if Ci is greater than R high, then we'll take the distance as Ci minus R high, and this is squared. And then we'll return the square root of this dx square and dy square. Okay, assume dx and dy are like this. Okay. So why are these spatial or geometric data, they are different? Because there is no natural ordering in one dimensional. We usually had a natural ordering on the keys, like integer, alphabet from A to Z, you know, order like this. Integer from 1 to say n, or minus 1 to some minus n. How do you order a set of points in 1D? And we take certain step back. In the 1D case, how did we use this ordering first of all? And mostly, we thought of partitioning the data. It gives us an implicit idea about the partitioning of the data. So instead of explicitly ordering and implicitly partitioning, we'll use the explicit partitioning here. So partitioning is a very natural phenomena in geometric shapes or spaces. In 1D, let us see the static case first. Usually in the static case, where all data are known at the start, in the beginning, may not be so interesting, but this can be solved by sorting the data. You can use this heap, you can get a sorted list, balanced tree, you can perform the binary search. But with geometric data, it's sometimes hard to answer queries even if all the data are known. What's the analog of binary search for a set of points? Can you answer this? And in this case, we emphasize update on the update less. We'll consider them, but still we emphasize on the update less. So the model is, we pre-process the data in the order of n log n, and then have efficient answer to the queries. And right now, the point data set is data we want to store in a collection of d-dimensional points. So we'll focus on a 2D for now. And the simplest query would be, is point P is in the collection? This is our PR quadtrees. You know, P stands for point. PR quadtree, this is point region, PR point region. We recursively subdivide cell into four equal size subsets until a cell has only one point in it. Each subdivision results in a single node with four children, or four pointer. When cell contains no points, we add special no point node. This, when the cell contains one point, we add node containing point plus the data which is associated with that point, perhaps a pointer out to a bigger data record, it can be. So this is the representation of your PR or point region quadtree's internal nodes. First, if this is the main region, we divide it into four parts: northwest, northeast, southwest, southeast. And then depending upon the points, we are going to subdivide it. Like we have just subdivided it in the way which is possible for us. Okay, now it depends on the points which are coming. So when we come here, we see that we can divide this point region into, because these are two points, so this is our option. And now we have four here. Again, for this region also we need to divide. So these are the two points. And for this region, see, we can further subdivide it into this one. Okay. And because these two points are again, so we need to subdivide it. And for this, there is no requirement. Okay. This is how we subdivide the internal nodes. So ultimately, you'll get this L. You start with the L, then you come to M and Q. So these are the M and Q point, because they are already subdivided into N. This is N, and this is your P. This is your P. Here you have divided it into R, again to 4. And you have certain nodes which are saying that which is the null, which is not the null. Okay. So these two are null. This is null. This is again null. So this is one is the null. We have certain points here, 1. So we took it. So how to find in PR quadri? If you are interested in some point, you can just go to that level, that is, you want to find some point here. So first we'll go to the L, say we go to R, now this Q or any M, we go to the R, and first Q, and then you go to the R, and then you are interested in certain points, so you can get the point here. So inserting, first you have to find and then you have to insert. So in inserting, you find point P. If cell where P would go is empty, then we'll add P to it, we'll change this block to filled block. If cell where P would go has a point Q in it, we again split until P is separated from Q, and then we'll add Q to correct this cell. So how many times you want to split? Okay. What about deletion? In a deletion again, we want to find the point P. If the cell that would contain P is empty, we return not found. Okay. Else we'll remove P, change this to this. That is how we delete. If at most one sibling of the cell has a point, we merge siblings into single cell and we repeat until at least two siblings contain a point. A cell has a point if it is filled or it is the root one. So what are these the features of PR quadtrees, that is point region quadtrees? The locations of splits, they don't depend on the exact point values. So it is actually the partitioning in the space, not of the set of keys. Please understand. The partitioning is in terms of space, not in the set of keys. And the leaves should be treated differently than internal nodes, because empty leaf nodes are common, you'll find it. And only leaves and leaves will contain the data. And the bounding boxes constructed on the fly, and they are again passed to the recursive call. So this is a recursive definition. We have an extension also. We allow a constant which is b greater than 1 points in a cell, which is called as a bucket quadtree. What about the height lemma? Let us see. If you have C, which is the smaller distance between any two points, these two points, and S is the side of length of initial square containing the point, then the depth of quadtree would be log S by C plus 3 by 2. Right? So you can easily find out, you know, this is a proof. The internal node is of depth I, that means it goes up to side length S by 2 to the power I. And of course, the diagonal distance would be S root 2 by 2 to the power I, if we consider S is the side length of the initial square. So this is our diagonal, so it is S root 2 by 2 to the power I. It is always greater than or equal to C. C is the smallest distance between two points. So this we take the log, and log S root 2 C, I will be less than or equal to log S root 2 by C, taking the log of this point. So log S by C plus half, this can be represented, you know this, how to represent the log. So the height of the tree is maximum in maximum depth of internal node plus 1. So height would be what? Log C by 2 plus half plus 1, that is log C by 2 plus 3 by 2. So the depth of the quadtree will be log S by C plus 3 by 2. We also have a size corollary, that is the depth of or the quadtree of depth D storing n points has order of D plus 1 into n nodes. Right? The proof is very simple. Every internal node represents a square with at least two points in it, hence the level has a fewer than n nodes. What about the north neighbor? North neighbor. North neighbor of a cell, say S, is the deepest node of depth which is less than or equal to this I, that is adjacent to the north side of the S. Okay. So the north neighbor of southwest or southeast node is in northwest or northeast respectively. As we said, we have four partition. Okay. This is northwest, this is northeast, this is southwest, this is southeast. So we are interested in the north neighbor. North neighbor. Okay. So north neighbor of a northeast or northwest is a child of the north neighbor of its parent. So the algorithm would be to find out the north neighbor. We walk up until you get an easy case, we apply easy case, and then walk down moving to southwest or south, whichever is appropriate. This is the algorithm for north neighbor. You can just check it out. We have various softwares or the application which are built. So you can easily give the values and you can find out how the quadtree will be. So you can just place the values and you will find the quadtree being building. So all these are the link, you can go and just find it out. What are the advantages of PR quad tree? As we have just seen the PR quad tree. Since partitioning of the location, this don't depend on the data points. So two different set of data can be stored in two separate PR quad tree. That is, the partition location will be the same. For example, a quadrant Q1 in T1 is either the same as or superset of or a subset of any quadrant Q2 in T2. Right? So you cannot get partially overlap quadrants, and recursive nature is always clear. But there are certain issues with the PR quad tree. This can be inefficient. If you have two closely spaced points, they may require a lot of levels in the tree to split them. Again, splitting. So the inefficiency can also be you have to divide up space finely enough so that they end up in different cells. The other problem is generalizing to large dimensions uses a lot of space. For example, octree. This is just quadtree in 3D. So each node has an 8 pointer. So in D dimension, each node has how many pointers? 2 to the power D pointers. For D equal to 2, the nodes will be 1 million children. This is too high. Then we can just split and merge the decomposition. We subdivide into uniform blocks. And then we merge similar brothers like this. What are the similar brothers? These are the similar brothers. Okay, we just combine them. And we subdivide the non-homogeneous cells because these are non-homogeneous. And we group identical blocks to get the regions now. Now we have MX quad tree. This is very good for our image data because smallest element known is the pixel. So the space is recursively subdivided until small unit is reached. And we always subdivide to smallest unit, that is the MX tree. This is an example of MX quad tree. Again, the same location will show you the MX tree, how it can be implemented. And you can see the live example also. So MX tree is nothing but the matrix tree or quad tree. So the points are always at the leaf, okay? And all leaves with points are at the same depth. All leaves at the with the points are at the same depth. And the shape of the final tree is again independent of the insertion order. This is matrix quad tree. And in the matrix quad tree, the shape of final tree is independent of the insertion order as we have just suggested. And this can be used to represent a matrix also, especially 0-1 matrix. Recursive decomposition of matrix, which is given by MX tree, can be used for faster matrix transposition and multiplication. And then compression and transmission of images can be done. That is, you can have a progressive transmission in the terms of hierarchy. And transmitting high levels of the tree gives you a rough image. And lower levels, you get more detail. Okay? High level, rough image. Lower level, more detail. So this requires points which come from finite and discrete domain. The point quad tree, which is similar to our PR quad tree only. We have seen PR and MX and now point quad tree. Except we split on points in the data sets rather than just evenly dividing space. So we are handling the infinite space and we have special infinity value, which is actually allowing a rectangle to extend to infinity in some direction. And we assume a global bounding box. So this is a point quad tree. Now divide with respect to the point. How about insertion in point quad tree? We find the region. Inserting means first we find the region that would contain the point P. If P is encountered during the search, we report that okay, it is duplicated. And we add point where you fall off the tree. Yes. This is again a same description of point tree because there are various point tree data structure available. And you can just go to this location and find out yourself. The deletion from point quad tree, you can reinsert all points in the subtree rooted at the deleted point P. This can be somewhat expensive. There are some other ways to delete that work well under some assumption about the data. What are the performance fact? The cost of building a point quad tree is order of n log 4n with random insertions. The base is 4. The expected height is order of log n. Again, the base is 4. And the expected cost of inserting the ith node into the d-dimensional quad tree is 2 by d ln I log n plus order of 1. And we have more balanced point quad tree, which are optimized point quad tree. We want no subtree rooted at A to contain more than half the nodes under A. This can be some point. We assume you know all the data at the start also. So we sort the point lexicographically. Primary key is X attribute and the secondary key is the Y coordinate. Then we make the root. Then we find the median of the list, which is middle element as the main root. And we half the element, then we on the left root, half on the right. And we recursively apply the top and bottom halves to the list. We also have a pseudo point quad tree, like this point region quad tree, is that their split does not occur at data points. And like point quad trees, actual key values will determine the split. So we determine a point that splits up the data set in the most balanced way. Overmars and Van has pointed out, for any n points, there is a partitioning point so that each quadrant contains less than equal to the ceiling of capital N by D plus 1 points. When we compare the point base with the tri-based quad tree, tri-based is actually MX and PR trees. So point with the tri-based, tri-base that is MX matrix and point region, they rely on regular space decomposition, while the point base tree, the data points, they are in internal nodes. The data points associate only with the leaf nodes in these tri-based, and the deletion is quite simpler and shape are independent of the insertion order. In the point-based quad tree, the data points are internal nodes, they often have fewer nodes and deletion is complicated and shape depends on the insertion order. But there are problems with point quad trees also. They may not be balanced, but you know, expected to be if points are randomly inserted. Size is bounded in n, so partitioning key space rather than in the geometric space. Because each node contains a point y, a point, you must have at most n nodes. But many may have lots of unused points if d is large. The solution can be k-deep trees. So this was a basic idea about the quad trees.